Big shout to the ghosts and the ghostettes. On this episode, we talk about 1% of patch meanings. We get into another batch of them. Stay away from these patches. We also talk about Heathen Nation. I don't like putting people down, but we have to address it. Got a lot of emails with different patches. We're going to break those down on this episode of Demons Row TV. And oh yeah, we ghosting, baby. Shout out to the ghosts and the ghostettes. Welcome to Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture, where we cover everything motorcycle club involved. I'm Sos the Ghost. I'm your host for the evening. And since I did that last video about 1% of patch meanings, I've been getting a lot of emails with a lot of different patches. So we're going to do a review on a whole bunch of other patches that people sent in. Things that they want to know if it's okay for them to wear it. We're going to talk about Heathen Nation because a lot of people been hitting me up about the clothing that they got with diamonds and all that type of stuff on it. But the first thing I want you to do, like we always do on this channel, is to hit me with that pound ghosting. And that lets me know you're alive and well, sitting on tools, doing what you do, or just part of the Demons Row community. One of my ghosts. Big shout to all my new subscribers. Welcome to the row. Make sure you hit the bell so you get the notifications. Hit the like button and share this with people that you know that wear things that are out of pocket and they have no reason putting on. Follow my second page, the Sos the Ghost page. We got a new video that just dropped on there. Shout to everybody that's been getting the pins and the stickers and the Demons Row clothing. I appreciate you truly for that. And let's break down some of these patches and some of these emails I got. The email is demonsrow@gmail.com. If you have patches that you want reviewed or videos that you want questions on, send them to demonsrow@gmail.com. All right, the first patch I want to get into is Filthy Few. Now people see this and they think it's fine, it doesn't matter. Now, people in the culture already know that this is a dead giveaway, but like I always say, this is for the people that don't understand. That's why I do this. Filthy Few is an 81 patch. It is a Hell's Angels inner circle type of thing. This is something that they do. So if you put this on, you can get yourself in a bad situation. All right, let's break down the MC cube. When you see the MC in the cube, a lot of people think that this MC is just motorcycle club, anybody could put it on. That is not true. There are clubs out here that don't wear a cube, that are official, that have respect, and still in the town they live in, they cannot wear the MC cube. It's split. It's on two sides of their center patch. So if you get yours from the store and you just say, oh, well, it says MC, there's nothing wrong with that. What you're doing is, in essence, saying that something that they can't achieve because of the section they're in, that you yourself going to the store achieve that. So don't minimize anything in this culture. These patches, a lot of them mean something. I wanted to read this comment from Flying Val. People have to eventually understand that the patches on a biker's cut simply put his ID in the biker world. If they are not in the club, be that MC, MA, RC, etc., it doesn't matter. They don't need patches that look like club colors in any shape or form, or patches that represent things they have never done before. I have seen people putting on patches they don't know anything about just to look cool. This is so true. And the way he broke it down as an ID, that's basically the way to look at it if you don't understand the culture. It's like your ID, but in the end, it has the opposite effect. Not only do they not look cool, they look stupid. So you throw on these patches and you think that you're looking cool and you're looking like other people and you're trying to fit in, Really, the people in the know just look at you like you're dumb and you lack knowledge. Having said that, thank you for this video. By making it, you have saved people from getting themselves in difficult situations. Much respect from Crete. So he's all the way in Crete. Our Demons Row community is international, so that's a blessing. Now, another brother who will remain nameless sent me this diamond patch, and it's a military patch that he got when he was out serving. So my thing is with this, like, yes, military gets nothing but respect, but I know from brothers that are in other areas that this won't fly. That just because you were in the military, they're not gonna respect you walking around with a diamond patch with stars, like you have stripes in the game like that. And this isn't in all states. Some states, you know, might have some military and they know and they respect it, they're old timers or whatever, but there are certain places where a diamond, period, just the fact that it's a diamond shape, it won't fly. Now this one, I got so many emails on that I'm not even gonna just read one, and it's the Heathen Nation. And listen, I'm gonna say this, man, I support all local business. Like, big shout to Rod of Iron Ministries, Pastor Sean Moon. He got dope shirts. Shout to Outlaw Vikla. Shout to Gangsta Vikla. Shout to everybody that has their own business. Now, this Heathen Nation right here, I'm not going to down their business because that's not what I do. If you like some of their other stuff, then support it. I'm not saying don't support it. But this one right here is wrong in so many ways. First, if you wear something like this and you jump on a motorcycle, you're giving the impression that you're Mr. Super Diamond. You don't got one diamond on the back, you got two diamonds on the back. So you're super one percenter. And they got the 01 in it and then the 20. And it's like, why would you sell this and put people in that type of situation where somebody could see that and mistake them for somebody else? Or just, you know, get their shirt ripped off, made to be look stupid. You know what I mean? Like, I don't understand why they would push this. Somebody must have had some type of knowledge about MC culture to do this, because why would they affiliate the diamond to it? So if you know that, why would you do that? But then again, maybe they just saw it and thought it looked cool and then reverted it. And I don't know. Let me know in the comments what you think. But me, this is a no-go all the way. Any diamonds like this is going to be a problem. Now, this one right here, expect no mercy. You might look at this as just the same, but you see the colors, red and gold. This is Bandido's territory that you're jumping in. This is why I say this patch right here, I think, is the perfect example of what I'm talking about on this show. This seems like something that you could just buy at a store and it's okay, but this is something well respected by a top club. So you don't want to throw on any patch that you have no knowledge of. You need to do homework on any patch. And I know, listen, I got one right here for the trolls. For the people that's going to jump in the comments right now, I got something special for you. This is the patch for you right here. You are an official member of the Troll Army. And we know for damn sure you're not doing anything you say in real life. So another brother sent me this one, and it says, American, don't tread on me, certified white boy. So it's like, my thing with this is the three-piece rocker. Like, you're making it look like you're in the MC, and that you can't do that. And it's black and white, so you're looking like you're picking a side. I wouldn't go with this. And this is why I say, if you really want to patch up to this extent, three-piece patch, I would join a club if you really want to patch up like that. Now, important one that people have asked me about and that I want to cover is a Nomad, a bottom rocker, a side rocker. It doesn't matter what kind of rocker it is. If it says Nomad on it and you're not affiliated with anybody, you're basically running through a town telling whoever's the club of that town that you run everywhere through different towns. And if you're not affiliated, why would you want to do that? Because sometimes Nomads get sent to spots to set up shop to start a new charter. So you riding around with your Nomad rocker on, you know, trying to look cool, and then meanwhile the next club over is like, wait, he's not leaving, he's not really a Nomad, they're trying to set up a new chart out here. So that's basically what you're saying if you throw on a Nomad rocker and they see you all the time. Another brother sent me this crest, says Ellis on it. I don't see anything wrong with this, honestly. I don't know, let me know in the comments If anybody sees anything wrong with this, I don't see anything wrong with this one. One thing I wanted to address too that people didn't understand in the last video, I had made a statement and I said, I personally would not wear a leather vest if I was not in a club. That's just a personal preference. I'm not telling you that a leather vest is something that could get you into a problem, because I kind of think people were under that impression, because I kept getting asked that question. Oh, well, I don't see what the problem is with wearing a slick back, a plain black vest. There is no problem with it. I just said, me personally, I feel like that's a club look and I wouldn't go for it. That's just me. That's just a personal thing. But let's give light. This week's certified ghost stat goes out to Phoenix, cast member of the Real Femi Tales of Bike Life Down South, founding president of the Dallas Riding Club, Lady Luck. Big shout to Raven Dixie. Check out Raven Dixie line on YouTube. Phoenix, you are a certified ghost stat. This week's certified ghost goes out to JD Herbert, representing the EMS Road Docs Boston chapter. 30 years ago, he found the medical services as his calling, a way to help the sick and injured. He has been with the Demons Row community for a long time. Much love, my brother. You are a certified ghost. So if you know anybody that's certified ghost or ghost step material, follow me on Instagram at Demons Row, at SostaGhost underscore. Big shout to everybody. Be safe out there. I've been seeing a lot of videos of people getting ran off the road, a lot of craziness. Check us out on Sunday. We're doing a live call-in show every Sunday at 6 p.m. And thank you for tuning in to Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture. Like, subscribe, and comment. And oh yeah, we ghosting, baby.